Hello, Yugles. I am Stephen, and welcome to another TS review. This time, we're going to be having a look at a brand new DLC that's only just come out today, July 13th, 2016. Now, this DLC was made by Skyhook Games, the same people responsible for the Count of Monster Disco DLC. So it'll be quite interesting to see how a developer has gone from like a cartoonish sort of look DLC to sort of like a, in effect, a realism DLC. And the DLC that we're going to be having a look at today on My Garden Railway Route is none other than the highly anticipated Star Class. Look at these two ladies. Now you get two variations of the Star Class. You get the weathered version, as you can see here on, ironically, Evening Star. And then you got here the pristine state from Lodestar. Ah, oh, my baby's finally in the game. Finally! You also get three different types of coaches of the Sunshine variant of the Blood and Custard. No, sorry, not the Blood and Custard. Duh. It's the Chocolate and Cream. You get the Brake, the Composite, and you get the third here. You also get four career scenarios for the Riviera in the 50s route, so you would need the base game Train Simulator 2016 in order for it to work. Now, in terms of numbering system for the Star Class pack, you've got quite a varying amount of different names and numbers for these engines. You've got the first 11 members of the class from number 4000, North Star, all the way up until 4010, so 4010, which is Western Star. Those from number 4000 to 4010, you get the members of the class that are named in the Star series. And then from 4011 to 4020, the remaining members of the class within this pack anyway, you get the members of the class that are actually within the Knight series. So the ones that are in the Knight name. So you've got like 4011 Knight of the Garter all the way up until 4020 Knight Commander. So, DLC then. Well, in terms of looks, these engines are absolutely stunning. I mean, first of all, straight away, I can see inside Val gear, and just like the Castle Class, I hope to God these actually work. It looks like it does. I mean, for it's actually quite interesting to see a boiler underneath like this. Good. Oh, can't believe Lodestar's finally in the game. Oh, this is the clean state. I can't help but think that it is still slightly dirty in some respects. Ah, well, I'm sure someone will make a slight reskin to mod that in some way, I should think. Wow, that coal texture actually looks really nice. It's quite crisp and sharp as well. That is really, really nice. Right, enough admiring. Let's get these engines going. So, if it's not already, press B. Right, we're in really, really realistic driving mode now. And zoom to the front. Now, the head codes, in terms of lamp arrangements, I believe it is similar to the Castle Class, where, yeah, you've got to cycle through H, there we go, so we're going to have it on the Express one, because why the hell not? Zoom right round, hop inside the cab, very, very nice. Take the brakes off like that a bit, shut the regulator. I can't help but think that the cab on this Star, on the Star Class, really is shallow and doesn't give you much protection, unlike, say, for example, the Castles of the Kings. This is probably, probably sounds weird, but this is probably the most open cab of all open cab Great Western engines. Put on the small ejector, large ejector, cylinder cocks down there. Make sure that the dampers are on, which they are. Oh, what camera views have we got? We got that one. Oh, let's have a look at the firebox. Let's see what we've got in there. Oh wow, that's quite interesting. That's quite neat. And then over here, hold on. What the, is there a font stamped into those doors? There is, isn't there? I can see an R, but what does that one say? Oh, LR, left and right. Ah, okay. I suppose they did that so that when they maybe even took them off when these engines went into overhauls and such, maybe they knew that which one was which. Who knows? Oh, I've just noticed. Oh, do these seats work? Do these seats fold down? Oh my god. Oh my god, the seats fold down. That is amazing. Right. Let's wind you all the way forward. Ah, the reversing lock. Very, very nice. Right, so, the whistle. Shut the large ejector. What does the whistle sound like? Same from that from the Riviera 50s King and Castles, I believe, so that's fine. Do we have any bell whistles in terms of like maybe shift space? No. Control space? No. Shift B? No. Okay, it's just the main space bar whistle. Okay. It doesn't matter though. I mean, look at the star class, for God's sake. It is lush of the luscious. Right, so back over here. Dum, bum, 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 bum. Yeah, so, oh, one thing I will do is that, pop over here. Now, one thing I will say is that I do apologise for the lack of videos recently. I've not been very well, and I just didn't want to record anything or upload anything whilst I'm basically sounded really horrible, to be quite honest with you, and I'm sure you wouldn't like to hear me sound any different either. So, away we go. Come on, load. Come on, girl. Wind it back a bit. Yeah. Sounds really nice. Now, one thing I will do is that if we go into the map view, I'm going to diverge off here so that we can then go around onto this beak loop here to really get some speed up. Yeah, that's all set, that's all set. Bring that back round. What should we... Yeah, let's head back that way, so that means we will then have to come out here. Do another... Yeah, we'll do that. Send the cocks off. Wind you back a bit more, about there-ish. Small ejector shut. No, wait, not yet. Now we can shut it. As soon as we get to 20 miles an hour, you can shut the small ejector. Crease the reg open a bit. About there. Now, what camera views have we got? Ah. Oh. Yes, window hanging, my lords. One thing I want to see. Yeah, you can see it move. Look at that. Look at that inside motion go. There we go. That's a good view. I'll zoom in a bit. Oh, I just love stuff like that. That's what really makes a pack so good. Is it small little details like that can make a big difference? Oh, can't we open the beans yet? Hmm. Yes, we can open the beans. Power! Come on, Lodestar. Let's keep pace with the star, shall we? I know you guys like these sort of shots, so I try and do as best as I can. Star class is such a beautiful engine. I wonder if they'd ever do the prototype of 4000 North Star when she was originally a 442. I wonder if they'd ever do that. It would be really nice though. Just see those main rods and then see the inside motion going. Fantastic. Oh, we're about to enter the doom and gloom. Light on, please. Thank you. Oh, wow, that is beautifully lit up. Ah, oh, he does love the light effect just to the side here on the left. Oh, you can just give that. Go away. I like how you can just make out the lights from the coaches. That is really, really nice. Oh. Release the brakes. Must be on the flat section. And power. Come on, load. What's the fire glow like? Oh, the fire glow is quite cool as well. Actually, what's it like if I just turn, that lamp off? Oh wow, that's quite cool. Oh, back in the light again. At some stage, I am going to have to take a thumbnail. Come on, Lodestar. Oh, such a lovely engine. Oh, along here will do, along here will do. So bear with me. Right, thumbnail taken. Slow down a bit. I think we'll stop in the platform we started off with and then we'll call it a day. Ah, this pack is so nice. That's it, they'll come to a stop. So, the Star Class from Skyhook Games, available on Steam. What do I think of it? Very nice, for one thing. It comes with quite beautifully detailed rolling stock. The loco itself is absolutely sublime. It comes with It comes with a reasonable amount of scenarios, albeit only four career ones for the Riviera in the 50s. You do get quite a lot of numbered and named versions of the class, which is quite nice. You've got two different states, clean and weathered. And for, as it currently stands, for £11.99, in British pounds sterling that is, it is actually worth it. I really do highly recommend getting this pack. I just can't get over that inside motion though. I love it when stuff like that is added in, it's so nice. It really is nice. Why is it I always have an argument with an engine that always has to blow off all the time? Lodestar, please, will you shush? Will you shush? Will you shush? Please? For me? No? Oh. Every time I tell all the other engines to shush, they do it, but you... Madam. Okay, now you do it. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, you guys. Hope you enjoyed this review. In terms of ratings, what do I give this pack? Definitely a 10 out of 10. Go out and go get it. If you want to see more reviews like this or more videos, please be sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe for more content, and I'll see you all in the next video. Ta-ra, you guys. God, this pack is so nice.